to our next important speaker, who is also part of the steering committee. That's Duncan Steele, the Deputy Director and Strategic Lead for Enteric Vaccines at the Global Foundation, the Gates Foundation, sorry. Duncan, can you speak to us to what motivated the Gates Foundation to be the founding donor to the country support platform? And what would you like to achieve in the next coming year?
Thank you, Dr. Benson, for the question, and thank you for inviting me to the session. Honorable Ministers, today's examples of country resilience in the midst of the profound challenges of the COVID-19 pandemic are really inspiring. Honorable Ministers, we see and recognize the sacrifice that you and your staff have made. The nurses and clinicians, program staff, community health workers have all had to endure and power through. And you are truly the heroes of the hour, and you have our profound gratitude. Following your example against COVID-19, we also need to keep up the fight against cholera. And even as we try and address it in the fight against the new threat of COVID-19. So Dr. Benson, to your question, the foundation has supported efforts to control cholera virtually since its inception approximately 20 years ago, including investments in the development of vaccines and studies to understand the epidemiology and transmission of cholera. Cholera vaccines are successful tools that can save lives. As mentioned by Dr. Weller, they provide a short-term opportunity for countries to curtail the impact of cholera, while the investments in systems and infrastructure needed to control cholera and other waterborne diseases in the long term are effectively put in place. We've made tremendous strides in the use of cholera vaccines through the GTFCC and the Gavi stockpile. And as Dr. Weller mentioned, over 100-fold more vaccines have been utilized by countries in the last 7 or 8 years. And so the country support platform is really the logical and necessary development of our collective efforts to support investments towards cholera control and elimination. COVID-19 has caused millions of deaths and diverted resources, personnel, and attention away from many essential health services, including cholera vaccination efforts. So we really do see the country support platform as a critical function of the GTFCC partnership. We believe that for this ancient problem of cholera, we need modern innovative solutions. We need a nimble, flexible mechanism which is dedicated to supporting cholera-affected countries. And there've already been some questions of this in the chat. This is the vision for the country support platform. In the International Federation of the Red Cross and Red Crescent, we have a rigorous and sophisticated partner that stands ready to scale up this mechanism to meet the multi-sectoral needs of cholera-affected countries. Finally, I encourage fellow donors to take advantage of this opportunity by directing your investments towards the interventions and control in cholera hotspots utilizing the country support platform. It is critical that WASH donors and investments are scaled up. We know that this is a long-term solution to cholera epidemics that we're seeing. We believe that cholera vaccines can act as a bridge to a cholera elimination while these resources are found and implemented in country for WASH. We've also heard the investment is needed in the surveillance and diagnostic laboratory capacity components where there are significant research, funding gaps. And this is another investment that needs to be considered. So I look forward to in the coming year to seeing the progress of the country support platform. We know that they have recruited and are building their teams, they're building their regional hubs. And we ultimately look to a world in which cholera, COVID-19, and all vaccine preventable diseases are no longer a threat to public health. We know that together we can look forward to a world which protects the most vulnerable people with a renewed opportunity for health and prosperity. Thank you.